What's going on YouTube? Jeans here, bringing you guys part 18 for my playthrough on Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Pokemon Shining Pearl for the Nintendo Switch. So guys, in the last episode, we made our way all the way over to Sunny Shore City and defeated the 8th and final gym. And in today's video, we're going to be making our way towards the Victory Road. You guys already know the deal. If you do enjoy the content at any time, make sure you support me as a content creator by leaving a like on today's video. And if you're not subscribed to the channel, come on, yo, subscribe to this channel. It only takes a second of your guys' time. All you gotta do is scroll down a little bit and click that big red subscribe button. So seriously, thank you to all my subscribers on this channel. But before we even get started on going towards Victory Road, I want to grab myself the TM Shadow Ball, which is over near Celestic Town on Route 210. So that is exactly what we're gonna do. It is in the fog area. Your boy does not have the fog, but the path is memorized. I know exactly how to get to the Shadow Ball TM, and we need this for my lovely little Froslass. Considering Froslass is a ghost type and is a special attacker, and Shadow Ball is probably one of the best ghost special attacking moves in the game, so that is what we want to get. We definitely want to get him, but we got to make our way over here up towards this guy pass, and then over all across this bridge. Yeah, okay, I got this path memorized. Once we get to this bridge, there should be a bike path to our left, which you can slightly see. Take this bike path all the way across, and then you take the bike path down, and of course there's a trainer over here. Of course, there's a trainer over here that we never did yet, so let me whoop on him real quick. I think I have my Torterra in the front, and this kid only has one Pokemon, so it's going to be Cakewalk. It's going to be Cakewalk. He's going to send out a Dustox. It's probably like level 23. Let me see this thing, yo. We haven't been in this area in so long, and now we have all 8 gym badges with the Pokemon pretty much leveled up really well. So we're just going to smoke on this thing. Let's see what he's got cooking. 27. We have not very effective moves, but hopefully Rage Sleep can still pick up the KO. I think it can. I think it can. Give it to me. Yo, come on, Torterra. Come on, Torterra. And you got a crit and you didn't even kill that thing? Come on, yo. Torterra, you're better than that. You're better than that. He's going to set up, what was that, a reflect or a light screen? It was a light screen, so. Physical attacking move, still doing as much damage. Razor Leaf should be able to take it out now. We send it again. Get this Dustax out of our game. I'm still a little upset that we didn't one-tap it, but defeat that little guy. Dang, dude, I thought we defeated all the trainers on this route, but we never headed to this area because if we did, we would have had Shadow Ball. We would have had Shadow Ball already, but now that we defeat him, we just have to head straight across this next bike path, which should be straight down, right? Can I find it? Yep, right here. And then it should be rocks, which we just rock smash, and a Pokeball should be over here with the lovely TM Shadow Ball. The lovely TM Shadow Ball, which is going to be great for my Froslass. Now, where's this Pokeball at? Right here. There it is. Found TM 30 Shadow Ball. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Now we can head back to Sunny Shore City, give this TM to my boy Froslass, and more importantly, start making our way all the way up this route towards Elite Four and Victory Road. What's the Pokemon League? Loving it, loving it, loving it. But this route towards Victory Road is actually a pretty decently long route. A lot of trainers on it, and they're all water trainers because you gotta like surf your way across. But let's give this a Froslass. Consider we're probably gonna be using Froslass a good bit, but I wanna use Lucario first. I wanna use Lucario first because, you know, he's a little under level, and we need to get his levels up. But the reason I am gonna be using Froslass is because we have Thunderbolt on him. Thunderbolt just works so good. Works so good, but let's give this to my lovely little boy Froslass, and now we finally have a good ghost move for this Pokemon. Because we had Hex, and Hex was like, aight, but, you know, Shadow Ball's where it's at. But, yo, I'm loving this thing's moveset. We got Ice Beam for Stab, we got Shadow Ball for Stab, we have Burns with Will-O-Wisp for physical attackers, and Thunderbolt for coverage? Yo, come on, yo, this team is looking amazing. This team is looking amazing. I absolutely love this playthrough team, but we have everything that we need, so let's just head up, let's go towards this route, and I think this guy will give us, like, Waterfall or something. Is that how it does it? Someone gives us something. Do you? Yeah, somebody, I was going to say, somebody gives us Waterfall, I believe. Because we don't have it yet. Howdy, Jasmine. My name is Jasmine. I'm the gym leader, blah, 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 blah. Then what gym leader were you? What gym? Oh, she was a gym leader in Johto, she's saying. And she gives us TM99s, which I believe is Waterfall, right? That lovely little Waterfall? Yep, Waterfall. Hit a move, so now we can make our way towards Victory Road. You guys need Waterfall in order to make your way up Victory Road, but it's a guaranteed get because every time you walk up this way, in order to go towards the Pokemon League, she's sitting there and she automatically gives it to you. So it's not like you can miss it. It's not like you can miss it, but now we are on the route. We just have to make our way surfing across all these, and yo, I didn't even know there was like this little land area. A little land area, but we got to face off against these trainers because, you know, we need that XP. We need that XP. Like I said in the last episode, the Elite Four trainers have a huge spike in levels. I think Cynthia's Pokemon are like level 60, so we definitely got to get up there. We definitely got to get up there. And, oh, yo, Luminion. I love this Pokemon. Was going to take it as my water type in this game, but ended up choosing Floatzel because Floatzel's sick. But Luminion is such a cool Pokemon. I really like it all around. But, yo, these Pokemon are same level than my, as my boy right here. That's my boy Lucario, so we should be able to put up a good fight. Get some good XP here as well. I think it's going to take 3 shots to KO. Show me 2. Oh, lovely. Dude, Lucario is so strong. He is so strong. It seems he's going to pop an Aqua Ring, get a tad bit of HP back, but it ain't competitive battle, so we're just going to dump on it. Aqua Ring is pretty solid in, like, competitive battles because you have protect and all that good stuff with leftovers. You can constantly get a stream of HP back, which is really, really well. But Forest Spirit's going to poke here. Get this Luminion out of my game, yo. This is our game. We're running this all day. But yo, look how out of level like my Togekiss is compared to everything else. 56. 56 this thing is. Lucario wants to learn Heal Pulse. Nah, yo, we ain't about that. We're all about just the special attack and moves on this Pokemon right here. But yeah, level 56. My Togekiss has just been popping off, getting a bunch of levels. Let's first up on this trainer. Like I said, we're probably going to have to do all these trainers. I want to get as much XP as possible. So when we get to the Elite Four, I do not have to do off-screen training or anything. I can just kind of roll in there, get after it, and defeat Cynthia. I'm not going to lie. Cynthia is a tough challenger. A very tough challenger. Especially in this game. Her levels are pretty high. And a lot of her Pokemon hit like a truck. And can one-tap a lot of Pokemon. Really, really good all around. But she has this little, what's Azumarill's first stage? It's Marill and Azurill. There it is. Oh my god, did I just realize that? This thing's Azurill. The other one's Marill. And then the third stage is both their names combined. I just noticed that. That's pretty cool. It's Azu and Marill combined. The first two evolutions combined to make the third evolution. That is really cool, actually. I'm just noticing that. I like that a lot. But yo, if you guys haven't checked out my Azumarill competitive VGC double battles in Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Pearl video, definitely go check it out. We use a Belly Drum Azumarill team, and it is broken. It is probably the strongest, well, one of the strongest Pokemon in this game. It's insane. Once you get Belly Drum set up, I'm telling you, you guys are sweeping teams left and right. It's crazy. If you guys haven't checked out the video, definitely go check it out. It's a great one. It's going. We sweep a 4v6. We sweep a 4v6, and then... It's just great. You guys gotta see it. I'm not gonna say anything about it. Just go check out the video. Leave a like over there. You guys already know the deal. But we'll make our way up this path. And I was confused at first because I didn't know we could find Pokemon on the route. But we found this little cool little tentacle. And not gonna lie, when I first started playing Pokemon, my first game I ever played was Leaf Green on the Game Boy. I did not like tentacle. I was like, yo, this Pokemon's stupid. It looks stupid. I don't like it at all. And now I absolutely love Tentacle's design. I think it's such a cool Pokemon. Poison and Water type? Come on, yo. It's so sick. It is so sick. You gotta love it. You gotta love a good old Tentacle. But yo, here's my boy, yo. I love how the swimmers have, like, the Pokeballs on their hands and are just, like, wiggling it around. It's so sick. But he's gonna drop off a nice little Mantic, and I'm hoping my Lucario can just, like, pretty much run this route. So we just get a crap ton of XP. But, of course, he's gonna be not very effective. That means we're gonna bring out a Froslass. Froslass are go-to on this route, but Lucario, you know, we try and level him up. We'll pop out, we'll get our Froslass out here, and we'll just Thunderbolt a lot of these Pokemon down. What's this thing gonna go for? He's gonna go for Supersonic, dude. That is the worst, man. I absolutely hate being confused in Pokemon games. It's honestly the worst, because you never know. It could always hit you, it can never hit you. It's just awful. And look, we got a nice little Thunderbolt off. It's so unpredictable, confusion, because sometimes you get hit, like... You lose your turn 3 times in a row. You hit yourself in confusion 3 times in a row. And then sometimes you hit your move 3 times in a row. There's just no balance to it. But he's going to send out Ramraid. We're just going to keep out our lovely little Thunderbolt Froslass. Just keep sending him his way. We snapped out of confusion, so confusion wasn't even bad. We were complaining for nothing. Jeans was being a little baby. And we take out Thunderbolt with Ramraid. There you go. Get out of here. But yo, the water in this game looks so good. It looks so good. Like, even though, like, the chibi design doesn't, like, really, like, match it, the water still looks phenomenal. Like, even look at the water, like, in this battle right here. The current's moving pretty cool. It looks dope all around. I really like it. I really do like it. He's gonna send out a Mantine. Thunderbolt should be super effective. And do we KO? We do not. We do not have enough mustard in the tank to actually KO. And this thing is just going to use a Spounce and spring up top. And we're gonna pop a Shadow Ball, just because I want to see the animation of Shadow Ball. Even though I'm pretty sure I know what it looks like, but it still looks really cool. He's gonna drop a bounce, come from the sky, and I think that move looks so dope. It looks so dope, but let's pop our first Shadow Ball with Froslass. Yeah, yo, that move always looks sick. It always looks sick. I love how slow it goes. I love how it just, like, floats in the sky slowly, and then just explodes on him. It just looks cool. It's a cool animation. It's definitely a cool animation. I feel like it did have a cool animation back in the older gens as well, but this one, I feel like it's better than the older ones. But, yo, just take a second and look at this water. Look at the water, dude. They made it look so good. And I should be popping repels on this route. But yo, there's a Paloop. I love Paloops. Pelipper. Lovely little Pokemon. And I always contemplate having Pelipper on my team in every single Pokemon game. But at the same time, like, Pelipper's so cool, but he's water and flying, which are, like, main types for teams. There are just so many like cooler water and flying types, like in the game. Like for example, in this, like I'd rather go with like a Floatzel, a Luminion, or something, and then a different flying type like Staraptor and all that. But I'm gonna go into my bag right here, and pop a nice little Repel. You know, Repels are lovely. Do we have any? We do have some Max Repels. Let's pop it here and let's get moving towards our route. And of course, we can't go up that way, and we have a double battle cookie. So we have our Froslass and our lovely little Lucario in the front end, which is perfect. Which is just perfect. But back to what I was saying about Pelipper. Yeah, he's flying in water type. And every game already has, like, better flying water types. Like, just say if he was in Gen 1. There's, Pidgeot you can go with. And then, like, Starmie or Gyarados. Like, just something cooler. Just something cooler. Like, instead of using Pelipper, you can use up two different slots of your Pokemon team with flying and water types. It's just awesome. He was introduced in, what Gen was it? Gen 3. He was introduced in Gen 3. So, in that case, your water type would probably be either, like, Swampert or... What other water types would I use? Sharpedo is really cool. I did really like Sharpedo. And then, like, other flying types. What flying types were in that game? Why am I, like, drawing a blank on a bunch of flying types? What fly Pokemon did I use in Hoenn? I can't even remember. Because there's no Route 1 bird in that game, is there? Yeah, there's no, like, Route 1 bird. It's going to pop into my mind soon enough. But, yo, what flying type did I use? I think it was usually, like, Flygon, but you got him late game. You got him late game. So, Pelipper was a good pick in Hoenn. I'm not even going to lie. I'm not even gonna lie, it was a great pick in Hoenn. Because a lot of the Pokemon you get late game, I did usually always use Sharpedo and Sceptile, which was really my go-to squad. I really did like that all around. And I always did think, what's it called was really cool? Wailord, but Sharpedo was just my favorite. I absolutely love Sharpedo. Such a cool Pokemon. Such a cool Pokemon. But yo, I'm thinking Gen 3, like Pelipper might be the wave for Gen 3. Might be the wave for Gen 3. Why am I drawing a blank on all the flying types in Gen 3? I don't know why. Maybe there's just not that many. I kind of want to look them up right now. I kind of want to pull this up. Gen 3. I did like Breloom. I always liked Aggron. Sharpedo was cool. Any starter would work out. If I didn't go... If I need a fire type, Camerupt was pretty cool. Macargo wasn't too bad of a choice. Just drawing blanks, man. Just drawing a bunch of blanks. But I kind of... I vividly remember me always like waiting for the long haul to go with Flygon. Or Altaria. That was the other good one. Altaria was really good. Because you got him like after like the third or fourth gym. So Altaria was a great flying pick. Yeah, I kind of do think that. I think that was a good squad for me. Altaria, Sceptile, Sharpedo. And then sometimes I would go Breloom if I didn't go Sceptile. Because I absolutely love Breloom. One of my favorite Pokemon. And then the other ones I would just kind of like fill in the blanks and all that cool stuff. Just a really good gen. Just a really solid gen for that game. A lot of cool Pokemon in that generation as well. But now he's going to send out Wingull with Daddy Pelipper. The star of the conversation that we were just talking about. And I'm just going to pop an Aurora Spirit into this. And then, you know, Thunderbolt over on the Paloops. Paloops is going to go down to Thunderbolt. 4 times super effective. Drop him out. Get him out of my game. Get him out of my game. And, dude, I just can't get over how cool this team looks. I think we, like, perfectly set up the scene with all the coverage typing. We have so many typing that we cover a lot of different typings. Like, we have no repeat typing, which is awesome. And we have a lot of dual typings, which is great. Do we have any single typings? I think it's just... Yeah, it's just Floatzel who's single typing. Lucario has that Steel and Fighting. Frostlass has that Ice and Ghost. Houndoom has that Fire and Dark. Torterra's got Ground and Grass. And then Floatzel has Water. And Togekiss has Flying and Fairy. Yo, I just love the typing on this team. The team synergy is phenomenal. I think I did a great job just ripping up with the teams. But we got another trainer right here. And we're just whooping on trainers. Like I said, this route's a little long, has a lot of trainers on it, but we're here for the XP, and we kind of just want to use this episode to make our way towards Victory Road, and then in the next episode, we're just going to be tackling on Victory Road as a whole. Just doing it all in one go. So I think we'll have like 2 more videos left for the main story of this playthrough, and I'm definitely going to need you guys to let me know if you guys want to see a post-game playthrough of this game, where we do we go back, we revisit the gyms, we do some post-game stuff, all that good stuff. So definitely let me know in the comment section down below if you guys would like to see that. We can also catch more legendaries. We can do all that cool stuff. But you can, and we can also go get Garatina because you can get him post game in the little in that area. I forget what it's called. It's like the upside down void. I just call it the Stranger Things place because you know you kind of go like upside down. If you guys ever seen Stranger Things, that's what they do. They go to the upside down. I absolutely love that show. I think that's such a good show. Boys, Jeff's gonna fire. We're not gonna take too kindly in that. Actually, it's not very effective. Why did I think it was super? I'm stupid. And yeah, it poisons. Come on, man, get out my face. But yeah, I absolutely love Stranger Things. Cannot wait for the new season. Just such a solid watch. But I hate when shows like that or like Outer Banks come out. And this really goes for like any show. Like, but the most recent has been Outer Banks because I watch Outer Banks. When it comes out, it's like, oh, we have 9 to 10 episodes, and I watch them all in like 3 days, and then I like sit there and I have to wait 2 years for another season because I just watch them all in like 3 days. I'm like, come on, man. Like, where's the next season at? Now I gotta wait 2 years for it. And then by the time the next season comes out, I'm rewatching the whole show again. It's just a pain. It is just a pain. It's just awful. It's just awful, but it is what it is. But that is why I kind of like to watch like TV shows when people recommend them to me, to be completely finished. To just be completely finished so I don't end up getting hooked on it and then having to wait a year or two for a whole new season to come out. So if you're going to recommend me a show, make sure it's over with. Make sure the show's over with, because I do enjoy that a little bit more. He's going to throw out Wingull here, and Aurora Spear should KO it. We did KO a Wingull earlier with an Aurora Spear right in its beak, dude. Right in its beak, baby. Yes, sir, Wingull, get out of here. Get out of here. Can't handle us. Good old Wings, dude. Good old Wingull. Wingull's so cool. He's another Pokemon just like, Tentacruel, who I really didn't like back in the day, but now that I'm older, I absolutely love. I love Pelipper a lot more than Tentacruel, but I did not like Wingull or Pelipper back in the day. I was just like, oh, this Pokemon's kind of stupid, but dude, Pelipper is so sick. I love him. Definitely grew on me so much. We're just going to drop a Shockwave. This should 100% KO. We're level 56 with this lovely Togekiss. Thing's just a monster. This thing is going to carry us through to Elite Four, I think. I think a few of my Pokemon are going to die, and Togekiss is just going to come in clutch and rip through Cynthia. We just got to watch out for Cynthia's Lucario. That's going to be a problem for us. It's going to be a problem for our poor little Togekiss. So once we get rid of that Pokemon, my Togekiss can take out the Garchomp. We also have Frostlass take out Garchomp. It's going to be good. It's going to be good for us. And Togekiss will do a little bit better. Togekiss will actually do a lot better considering Garchomp runs EQ and Dragon Claw, and both those moves cannot hit Togekiss. That is awesome. That's why Togekiss is so good. It's just so good. There's my boy Swimmer Leslie sending out a Buizel. Yo, haven't we had this conversation like the past four videos? Why are these trainers still having low level Pokemon? No, not even low level. Why are these Pokemon not evolved yet? Like, come on, yo, evolve your Pokemon. Give me a little challenge. This thing's gonna pop an Aqua Jet. Gonna outspeed me. And Lucario's taking some hits, man. Might need to pop him a potion. He's taking some hits. Aurora Spear should be able to 100% KO this Buizel. Get him out my game, yo. Poor little Buizel. Kind of hoping he sends out a Floatzel. That'll give us more XP. And I can just get my Torterra out at that point. A Tentacruel. Okay, Tentacruel's going to come out here. And I'm just going to go Frostlass here. Lovely little Frostlass. Lovely little Frostlass. Even though Frostlass could die here to a Poison and a Water Pulse. Because we know Tentacruel's going to be able to soak up a T-Bolt. Lovely little T-Bolt. But we're still going to send it his way. I'm going to still say, hey, eat this up, buddy. He soaks it up, and hopefully he's not going for, like, a Water Pulse or something. Of course, my most hated move, Confuse Ray. And the thing is, we are taking a risk here. We are taking a huge risk. If we hurt ourselves in confusion, we die. Because we're going to take damage, he's going to hit us, and he's going to hit us with poison damage as well. So come on, Frostlass, clutch up for us. Yes, sir, Frostlass, MVP, all day. All day, Frostlass. Clutching up, snapping out of confusion. Not even snapping out of confusion. Just not getting confused. Just not hitting itself in confusion. Which is awesome. Level 52 for a Frostlass. 54 for Floatzel. And do you want to learn a move? No, he does not want to learn a move. We might have learned all the moves for most of our Pokemon. I know Torterra wants to learn Woodhammer soon. That's going to be a good move for him. That's definitely going to be a good move for him. But let's heal up our Pokemon. Let's heal up our Pokemon. Like I said, I'm trying to level up a lot of these guys. So, I want to keep Frostlass and Lucario pretty much at full health. It's gonna be really good. You know, they're our lowest level. Actually, Houndoom's level 50. We haven't touched shiny Houndoom. But he'll get some level. Don't worry, we got him all day. We got Sailor John over here, which we're gonna battle. Actually, I'm not gonna guess John. I'm gonna guess Sailor. Sailor Daryl. I don't know why Daryl, but it's probably gonna be John now. I would have never guessed Zachariah. Come on. Come on, Zachariah. Get out of my face, yo. He's going to send out Paloops. A lot of Paloops on the field. A lot of Paloops, man. Love this guy. Love this guy. And he's really good in competitive battle. Back to the Pelipper conversation. Really good in competitive battle. Sets weather, learns hurricane, and it learns like a water move, obviously. So it works super well with its weather. Considering hurricane hits 100% of the time, and its stab, and its huge damage. So it's just a great move in the rain. And then Scald or any other water move will get a water boost from the rain. He's just such a beast. He's like Gyarados. Really, really good. Just if he gets hit by an electric move, it's dead every single time. Because it's 4 times super effective to it. It's like Scissor up against fire. Scissor gets touched by a fire move, it's dead. Same thing with these guys with electric. They get touched by electric, they get on out of here, and they're dead. That's what I feel like. I feel like all the dual typings with four times weaknesses, they are super strong, but they have that, obviously, that four times weakness that really does them dirty. Just gonna switch to Machoke. We're just gonna swap it to our top tier Pokemon on the squad, Togebogey. And we're just gonna drop this thing with an Air Slash. A lovely little Air Slash. Actually, maybe a Gleam. Because I just love how this thing does like a twirl in the air. You know what? We are gonna use a Gleam. Because we're gonna make this thing do a little twirl. Ready for it, guys? Ready for it? Dazzle Gleam, do like a flip. The animation's so sick. Just looks like an airplane. Does like a spin and then curls up. Does like a triple axle spin. And just sends out a bunch of gleams of fairy beams to KO Pokemon. He's going to send out his final Pokemon, which is Gastrodon. And my lovely Torterra is going to thrive in here. And back to the four times weakness Pokemon. Gastrodon is one of them. Four times weak to grass. But again, it's super good. Learns a great ability with water, or not water absorb. It's a storm drain, which soaks in any water move, which is great for double battles. But, and it's really bulky, and it can hit pretty hard. It can hit pretty hard. But it's four times super effective to grass. So, that's his problem. That's the problem. Over here, we got my boy Torterra. Really, really good. Ice tears it up. Ice is four times super effective. Hits like a truck. Very bulky, too. Ice just tears up. It can usually soak up a special attacking fire move, too. And a physical attacking fire move. Usually can soak it up. Because it's just that bulky. But once it gets touched by ice, it's gone. It is gone. And another Pokemon just like that is Gliscor. Gliscor, four times super effective to ice. But is a monster. One of the best competitive double Pokemon in this game. So good. And competitive singles. It works really well in singles as well. We're making our way up this route. And we should be... I don't even know if we're halfway yet. I totally forget how far this one really goes towards. But we're making pretty good progress here. Pretty good progress. Getting all the XP. Like I said, we gotta first all these trainers. We gotta get all this XP just to make our way towards victory. And victory road's gonna be... I don't think it's gonna be that long. It's probably gonna be about 45 minutes, I think. It's a solid little route. It's a solid little route. But I do like victory road in this game. It's not my favorite victory road. I think Gen 1. Or Gen 3. Gen 3 might be my favorite victory road. Whichever one is the one where you have to drop the strength rock stones. The ones that you use strength on. Down into layers. It might be Gen 3. I think that might be Gen 3. Like, you're legit using strength, and you hit the rocks in a hole, and then they drop down to the next floor, and you have to go down to the floor and use the rocks onto another one. It's just such a great puzzle. Somebody let me know what generation that is. I believe it's 3. I believe it's 3, where you drop the rocks through floors, and then you use them towards your advantage to out-puzzle, or to solve the puzzle. That's my favorite victory room. That is my favorite victory room. Really, really good all around. That's what I didn't like about the Sword and Shield. They didn't have Victory Road. Victory Road's always good. It's always that tough little last path, little cave area that you gotta go towards to get to the Pokemon League. It's just awesome. It's just awesome. I always do it. I'm always like, okay, what does this Victory Road have to offer? How good is it? It's just a staple in all the Pokemon gens. So I was a little upset not to see Victory Road in the next gen. Wait, there was no Victory Road. There was not. And I don't think there was a Victory Road in the Sun and Moon either. Yeah, something that I think they should keep in all Pokemon games is Victory Road, the Elite Four, gotta be in each one. They didn't have that in Sword and Shield either, which I was sad about. They should keep gyms. I absolutely love gyms. That's just a staple. They should keep a fly, like one of those main flying types. You guys know what I'm talking about. Every gen has a main flying type. Like this one's Staraptor, Gen 1's Pidgeot, Gen 2's Noctowl. Like every gen has it. What other things should be staple in Pokemon games? I do like how they did HMs. I like how they kind of took out HMs as you do not have to learn them to a Pokemon. I like the HMs. I like the HM like move thing. Your hidden moves and you're in a different category. I like how they did that in that game. This was a good switch. But I think all those staples that we said should be in every single game. But there's definitely more. So if you guys have any other staples in Pokemon game that should be in every single game, let me know in the comment section down below. I'd love to get back to you guys and I would love to hear you guys' answers. I'm trying to think. What other ones do I really like? Because I know there's more. I know there's a lot more. But I just can't think of them. But there we go. Take out that Pelipper. Houndoom gets up to level 51. Loving it. Loving it. And we defeat Swimmer Cassandra. Give me your money. $820. Like how she's just swimming with money. Like, when your dollars get all soggy and everything. It's a little gross. That's a little gross, right? Soggy money. We don't deal with soggy money. Honestly, that is one of the worst things when you pull your clothes out of the washer or something and you pull out a dollar or it gets wet, so you jump in a pool with money in your pocket, and it's just like, ah. And then you leave it to dry out, and then it's super dry, and it's real crusty. It's just awful. It is just awful. This thing uses Intimidate. We're going to have to swap out because, you know, my boy ain't doing anything up against this Pokemon. We're just going to go into Tokus or Frostlass? I think Tokus has to come in here because if we send out Frostlass, I think this thing can just hit us once and kill us. We only has 66 HP, and Gyarados is a mean physical attacker. He's a mean physical attacker. We need out Tokus with 183 HP. And yeah, my Frostlass was not surviving Hydro Pump. Not one bit. Hydro Pump's too good. Too good. It's too good. Well, we'll drop a nice lovely Shockwave. This thing is getting out of our game. Get him out of here. Gyarados, you gone. Gyarados, you gone, baby. Drop that thing. Tokus does a little bounce. I like that. I like when the Pokemon does a little bounce. Gives me a sense of satisfaction. And we get a ton of XP. We got like 1,500 for our Lucario, which is really nice. And then we steal this guy's money. But is that the end of the route? It's looking like it. And we get to use Waterfall, yo. I love using Waterfall. Would you like to use another? Yeah, let's use another Repel. But yeah, dude, I love using Waterfall. It just always looks so cool. Because you get it late game, you're just like, yes, I can scale up Waterfalls. It's just like, yo, look at that. It just looks so sick. But here we are, guys. Make our way towards Victory Road. We come in here and heal up our Pokemon, which is awesome. I do like how they do give us a nice little Pokemon Center before tackling on Victory Road, because they know it's a little tough challenge. But Pokemon aren't looking bad. I feel like we might have to do some off-screen training when we get to the Elite Four. Hopefully, we can get a decent amount of levels when we defeat Victory Road, because there is a lot of trainers and a lot of ground Pokemon in there. But guys, that is going to be it for today's video. If you did enjoy the content, don't forget to smash that like button for me. And if you're new here, click that big red subscribe button so you know my videos go live. As in the next episode, we're going to be taking on Victory Road and making our way towards the Elite Four. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you all in the next one. Peace out, everybody.